I'm Richard Southern. Happy Victoria Day. You know, this is a day most of us get to step away from work and take a break. And boy, that could be a good thing, because new research shows many of us are literally working ourselves to death. A report from the World Health Organization found that 745,000 people died in 2016 due to working long hours. It's the first report of its kind, and there's concern that the pandemic could make the situation even worse for those struggling to find a work-life balance. Here's what researchers discovered. Working 55 hours a week or more was linked to a 35% higher risk of stroke and 17% higher chance of dying from heart disease. That's in comparison to those who work between 35 and 40 hours a week. Those who died were mostly middle-aged older men. Those living in Southeast Asia and the Western Pacific were affected the most. Well, travel restrictions remain in place across Canada, but Europe is getting set to open its borders, and that's leaving some to wonder if we'll be able to hop across the pond for a vacation this summer. The National Airline Council of Canada is asking the federal government to come up with a plan for restarting international travel. Of course, airlines have been absolutely hammered by the past 14 months by heavy restrictions and travelers needing to quarantine once they touch down in Canada. Ambassadors to the EU argued last week to ease some rules, allowing residents to move between countries as long as they've been vaccinated against COVID-19. Visitors from an approved list of foreign countries will also be allowed to enter the EU, but it's not clear whether Canada will be included right away. Well, you know we love food stories here on the City News Business Report, so let's look at a few of them, starting with a bold prediction about one of Canada's unofficial dishes. This story caught my eye a few days ago. A restaurant owner in Quebec believes poutine is set to become the next big food trend, just like burgers, tacos, and sushi. He's so sure that he's brought together members of the province's dairy industry to build an international branding strategy. The group is also looking to get official recognition from the Quebec government that could identify and protect poutine as a distinctive national dish. It's not clear if that request would involve restrictions on branding and the use of the word poutine. Meanwhile, what began as an April Fool's joke could become one of the top Insta-worthy drinks of the summer. Have you ever heard of an afternoon dill light? It's the world's first pickle-flavored seltzer. Yes, you heard right, a pickle-flavored seltzer water. The unusual concoction first popped up on social media on April 1st of last year. The response was so positive, it's actually been released this summer. But you'd better act quick. Only 10,012 packs will be produced. For City News, I'm Richard Southern.